The world is getting more and more complex. And this complexity is both technological. We have so many new devices, it's very hard to catch up with all these new technological developments. But at the same time, it's also more complex in a social area. Our relationships, our politics, becoming also more and more complex. All of this contributes to the fact that we have more and more uncertainty. We basically don't know what the future will bring. We don't know what will be the effects of our decisions. And we also don't know what will happen around us. How can we navigate this complexity? What tools do we have in order to make better decisions, to create better policies? One such tool is called social simulation. What is a social simulation? Basically, social simulations has three layers. On the lowest layer, it creates a model of reality. This is often what we can call biophysical, technological reality, something which we often have a quite a good grasp. And then, on this basic model, we add people. And people get into the roles. They not necessarily themselves. They can represent the roles which exist in our complex social reality, in the reality when there is a problem. We add to these roles certain rules. In a similar way, like in reality, participants are constrained by those rules. Finally, when we have this model and we have these roles constrained by rules, we add interactions. People enter the social situation and they make decisions. And this decision leads to consequences, which are discussed by other participants. They all negotiate, they develop strategies, they try to implement these strategies, but they also often get into the conflict. Sounds like real world. And that actually is. A social simulation is a way to represent the real world, to compress time and space in such a way that a group of people can think about these complex problems in a more manageable way. In other words, they can navigate complexity. So, how does it work in practice? Let's imagine that a group of people have a certain problem, a complex problem. They may want to face degrading quality of life in their city, or maybe they want to create a zero net emission region in which they live in. Or maybe they are threatened by certain disasters, which starts to become more and more regular because of the climate change. The first thing is that we need to invite different participants, different stakeholders, the people who affect or are affected by the problem. And these people, when they come to the meeting to join the social simulation, they bring different perspectives. They all think differently, they have different worldviews, and initially it causes some problems. So they come together and they start talking to each other. We have issues of communication, they don't necessarily understand each other, but they're trying, they keep talking. And step by step, they start to see how what they bring to the table is connected. So they start to see the relationships. Someone is talking about new jobs. Someone is talking about environment. Other people are talking about exclusion. And all these things are not no longer separate, but they start to see how they relate to each other. They start to see how the system is complex. And that's the big, very important point. Because at that point, they start to also understand other participants' perspectives. And when they understand the perspectives of different participants, they bring new creative ideas. Suddenly, they start to see, oh, we could create this solution which would not only take care of my problem, but also would be representing what other people want to have, the needs of other people. This is not an easy process, but if we have enough patience, if we allow people interact in this learning environment which social simulation creates, we increase the chance that they reach consensus, that they will be able to solve the real-world problems that they are tackling. With this interactive method, what we're trying to achieve is also that it's not only the intellectual understanding, oh, this is what we need to do to solve the problem, but they also brings or results in a commitment to action. So after the social simulations, they are ready to start working on the real world issue which they all face. There is commitment to action as a result of this process.